What's going on, everybody? This is Mortym bringing you part two of Guild Wars 2's Introduction to the Orders of Tyria as the Charr. If you remember from episode one, we are meeting up with the Dermond Priory to help discern the nature of the Necromancer's Amulet that we found in part one. So, we have to come up here and speak with Scholar Vivian, who should be in this priory building here, and we will see what she has to say about the current situation. Here she is, all the way up the very long flight of stairs.
Scholar Vivian, I'd like you to meet the Centurion who helped collect the Necromancer's amulet. I trust your team's analysis is going well.
We're making good progress, especially since we split the amulet up among three of our best researchers.
You were able to break the amulet apart? That sounds more like success than progress.
Each fragment remains functional, though. That tells us Rissa probably struck her amulets from the same original source. We're very close to a breakthrough. Check in with each of my team members and you'll see. You might even be able to speed things along.
All right, it looks like we have to go help her researchers. And we will start with these two, or Fiona here, on the ground floor. Okay, looks like she just needs to have us observe her tests.
Ah, the yellow brew.
So we pick a brew, and she drops the amulet in it.
That didn't seem to do anything. More dead ends.
Pick the red potion, see what that does.
Red! I love that color. Excellent choice. Okay, here goes nothing. Oh dear! Fire! Quickly, get the water veil before we lose.
Okay, so it looks like dropping the Necromancer's amulet in whatever that red brew was caused a fire. Now we just have to put them out.
Excuse me while I...
Okay, looks like we will go help Scholar Havris, since Fiona is a little indisposed.
I do most of my research at the pub.
All right, looks like he's going to try to just straight up break the amulet. And that summoned some undead. So we will put them down. All right, and now we have to check in on Scholar Emberbright and Mr. Cluckers, apparently.
Help! Cluckers is trying to eat my face! Kill him!
Well, it looks like that turned the chicken into a necromantic chicken.
The other shard I had. I'll miss him. At least he'll be an interesting dissection.
And now we speak with Scholar Vivian once again.
What do you need to know?
We've learned a lot about the crystal powering Rissa's amulets. It seems to be Orion Dragon corruption made solid. It resonates with death energy. It kills and reanimates the wearer, and then makes them into a focal point for other undead. Mr. Cluckers proved that the crystal fragments remain connected and are drawn to each other. If we can find the original source of this crystal, Fiona's reagents can nullify it, and we should be able to shut them all down.
Excellent work, especially in the face of an army of shades and an undead chicken. Now, how do we find the original crystal to nullify it?
I believe we can cobble together a locator device synced to the crystal's energy that would lead right back to the original.
Do it. We need to find the source, and I need to find my dead warband. Thank you, Scholar. Yahala, let's report back to the Citadel.
Okay, so we learned that the Necromancer's amulet is connected to an original source that we need to find and destroy. But in the meantime, we're gonna head back to the Black Citadel. Okay, so here we are back at the Heroes Canton in the Black Citadel, where we need to meet up with Ritlock and the Order representatives.
That's a stretch. Admire the view.
Who should be right up here.
The German Priory is looking forward to working with the Citadel on this Tribune.
As is the Order, whispers. The Dragons want us to come at them individually. That's why we should do it.
Glad to have you both aboard. We're going to need reliable information from here on. Not to sell the Vigil short. Their firepower is always an asset.
No need to flatter me, Tribune. I know researchers in the Vigil strong suit. As long as what we're doing eventually leads to the Dragons, we don't mind taking a back seat. Temporarily.
Okay, now that their little conversation is over.
What do you have for me? Eager to hear your report, Centurion. We're seeing an increase in undead attacks all over the region. Safe to say, Rissa's amulets are responsible.
We've learned that they're connected to the Orion Dragon. They turn their owners into undead, and draw other undead to them.
The Vigil has one of the amulets stashed in our HQ. Are you saying that my people are in danger?
You militant types ought to be used to that by now. With so many innocents at stake, the Vigil can defend itself. The Priory is working on a way to detect the amulets. We'll use our device to stop the next outbreak before it starts.
And if the Vigil falls, who will defend all those innocents it already protects?
And while you're working that out, I'll withdraw to confer with my superiors. You have a tough choice ahead of you, Centurion. What's it going to be?
So, for the sake of working with all the orders and mixing it up, we are going to go with Gone Tower Breaker and help defend the Vigil. And with that, we need to make our way to the Vigil headquarters, which is where we are headed next. Okay, so here we are at the Vigil headquarters, where we will be defending them from an undead horde.
You scared yet, rookie?
Should I be? I'm more anxious this way.
But first, we need to go find our representative, Gone Tower Breaker. I always really did enjoy the view of the Vigil headquarters. It's really impressive keep.
I haven't thought.
This place looks ready for war, Gon. I'm impressed.
After all this preparation and building up of our defenses, I'll be disappointed if we're not attacked. The plan is simple. The ramp you just came up is the only way in. We've set up barricades to slow down and thin out attackers. You can also use those cannons to welcome our undead visitors. If they get through all that, we fall back to the keep. That means you too, Centurion. Our house, our rules. We want live soldiers, not dead heroes. If the Vigil falls back, you fall back. Clear?
Clear. Is there anything I should do in the meantime?
And with that, it looks like we are being attacked. So, we man the defenses, which I believe is an arrow cart or a catapult of some sort. Ah, cannon. Good stuff.
We need artillery support. Get on the cannon.
Okay, so let's just start firing rounds here. Trying to hold off these undead. So it doesn't look like we really do that much damage with this thing. But we will try to place our shots appropriately. Although with them talking about falling back, it's more than likely that that's what we'll need to do. Thank you. And quite a few of them just spawned. So it looks like we will be falling back. Okay, so we're backing up with our representative over here to help defend. And we will hop on one of these arrow carts real fast. There we go, there's some range. Seems like it's gonna take a second for that horde to actually make its way up here. There it is. And as you can see, we're hitting that horde pretty well. But there are always more undead, as that is the way it goes. We will let our friends here handle the majority of the ones that are on us. Although, it looks like I'm losing a little too much health to do that, so we're actually gonna have to back up. We'll try to put these ones down here. Hop back on our cart here. Try to switch to the other one, get a better view. Looks like it slowed down to a bit of a trickle here, so hopefully we only need to kill a few more before this actually progresses. Quite a few dead soldiers up here. We'll at least get Urail here on her feet. There we go. Finally moved on a little bit. So we will focus on killing these abominations. All right, there's the first one down. Jump out of the way of his charge there, as that does hurt quite a bit. Alright. Well, if Gon would help us out at all, but luckily he was pretty much dead already.
Scorch me. What were those things?
Zaitan. And we're going to keep seeing more. More undead that are more dangerous than usual. More often.
They weren't playing around, were they? Is it just me, or are these amulets getting stronger?
It's definitely getting worse. And if an amulet isn't even safe inside a Vigil fortress, it's time to rethink our approach. Let's get back to Ritlock and the other orders. We need to stop these outbreaks before the landscape is hip deep in undead.
Agreed. I need to deal with our casualties here, and then I'll meet you back at the Black Citadel.
Alright, it looks like we have successfully defended the Vigil Keep. Although, successfully might be a bit of an overestimate. But either way, we're headed back to the Black Citadel. Okay, so once again, we are at the Black Citadel, speaking with Ritlock Brimstone. Although that said, this time we are outside. And it looks like there's a bit of a gathering.
The orders disagree on how to proceed, so I have a plan. You choose which one will help. In return, I've arranged for you to permanently join that order. You'll still be a centurion of the High Legions, but you'll also be a link between us and your chosen order. Your warband will continue doing Citadel business while you're gone.
I understand. Hal's involvement made this personal. But the Orion Dragon is a global threat. We need strong, reliable allies against it.
Okay, people. Time to decide. We have the means to find the Necromancer's Dragon Crystal. And to destroy it.
All thanks to the Priory. We know what we're doing. So now let us destroy the crystal without interference. We work better that way.
There's no way I'm leaving a vital search and destroy mission to a bunch of academics. Wait for Vigil support before you make a move.
Either way, the Order of Whispers will do what we always do. You draw their attention, then strike from the shadows.
It's your call, Centurion. But remember that you're not just helping out. You're joining the order you choose.
Okay, so I need to talk to my warband real quick.
I overheard. You're leaving us to join one of the orders.
I'm accepting a special assignment from the Tribune, and the warband will need a leader while I'm gone. That's you, Legionnaire.
Me? But we're the heart of this warband, you and me. If you're gone, I'm just a bad-tempered spellcaster that everyone's afraid of.
I need someone I can trust, someone effective. You've got some rough edges. But there's nobody else I'd want calling the shots. If anyone objects, send them to me. Or just crack their heads until they think different. You're in charge now. Act like it. I know you can handle this.
Thanks, boss. You can count on me. Good luck in Lion's Arch. We'll be waiting when you get back.
Okay, so we promoted Uriel to Legionnaire of the Warband while we are gone. And personally, we are going to help out the Order of Whispers, because that is the order I would like to join. So let's go ahead and talk to Korukan the Blacksmith.
I was hoping you'd sign with us. Your attitude and skills make you perfect for the Order of Whispers. You'll go far here.
I like the way you operate. You draw no attention, you keep the enemy guessing, and you get results. That's all a good soldier ever wants, to get results and stay alive. So, the Necromancer's Crystal is out there, and so is Hal. What's our next move?
Eager to get started, eh? Good. The Priory and Vigil muster in Lichcroft Mere, but there is danger. Meet me there, and we'll make sure they don't get in over their heads.
Okay, so we are headed to Lichcroft Mere to finish up the introduction to the orders part of the personal story. So that is where we will go. So here we are for the last part. We just need to speak with Korukan.
There you are. Time to start earning your keep, Initiate. The Vigil and Priory teams have already moved in, so our path is clear.
If they're already gone, then what's our objective?
If the Priory falls short and the Vigil get themselves killed, we step in and save the day. As usual. We heard the sounds of combat recently, so we may already be needed. The first thing we do is find the other squads.
This is your show, Korokan. But for the record, I don't like it. Carry on. But I'm coming along to make sure this gets done right.
Always a pleasure to have you with us, Tribune. If we need any heroism or noble, attention-grabbing antics, it's all you. Now let's move out.
Okay, so first off, we need to go locate the Vigil forces.
Look, some stray cats have come to die with their friends.
Okay, now that we have them out of the way, it shouldn't be a big deal to reach the Vigil forces, which I believe are on top of this hill here.
The Vigil squad is down, all of them. So that's what happened to Howl's body. Don't hold back, Centurion. That's not...
And it looks like there is our old Legionnaire, and all his undead glory. Okay, so we have dealt with our old Legionnaire Howl. And now we simply need to go find the Priory team that more than likely met the same fate. That said, we're gonna have to move through some of these guys and try to avoid the plague carriers because they blow up. Okay. Other than just a couple of them, it seems like a fairly straight shot over there now. Looks like the area itself, however, is a bit full of them. See if we can't kill them without dying here. Activate our ultimate and put torment on everything while we run around and make it follow us for some extra damage. There we go. Now we just need to speak with.
Take this potion. It'll destroy Rissa's crystal. You have to finish it.
Okay, and with the Priory, she gave us the potion that we need to destroy the Orion artifact that is causing all this trouble. And it should be in this cave here.
You've caused us all. Death is long.
Okay, so first of all, we're going to have to get rid of all of these undead she sent out. like so. And now we just have to deal with Rissa herself. Which shouldn't be a big deal considering the sheer number of people with me. Alright, now we need only destroy the crystal.
It's done. Korokan, Centurion, let's move out before this thing blows.
Okay, now we need to retreat before it apparently blows up.
Losses here today, but we did manage to stop the necromancer from drowning us in undead.
It's not enough. The Orient Dragon is still out there, and it's going to keep making undead until the whole world drowns in them.
Then it's time to take the offensive. The dragon is our target, just like the crystal was. We kill it, we cut off the flow of Orient undead at its source.
That's too ambitious, Initiate. The Order of Whispers is dedicated to stopping all the dragons, but we don't have the resources for direct confrontation.
Don't tell me about dragons, Blacksmith. Ever heard of Destiny's Edge? I was a member. We nearly took down an Elder Dragon all on our own.
We should find out what they know. Their experience could prove invaluable.
You're right. The Charr can't do this alone. Fortunately, I heard from one of my old guildmates. She wants to meet in Lion's Arch about that very thing.
Lion's Arch is also your next stop, Initiate. There's a Whispers contact waiting with your first official mission. Look for a vendor selling apples. Good luck.
I'll keep an eye out for you in the city. If we're lucky, we'll get another chance to fight together. Do the Legion's proud, soldier. Dismissed.
Okay, and there you have it. That wraps up the Char's introduction to the Orders of Tyria. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. This has been Mortym. If you did enjoy it, please subscribe. But I hope you guys have a great day, either way it goes.